big prize, though, on both sides tomorrow is Arizona. Arizona has long been seen as friendly territory for Hillary Clinton. She beat Barack Obama in the Arizona primary in 2008 by nearly 10 points. Bill Clinton also won Arizona in the 1996 general election. To this day, that's the only time a Democratic presidential candidate has won Arizona in a general election since Harry Truman. And this time around, the polls look good for Hillary Clinton in Arizona. The most recent poll in the state has her up by 26 points over Senator Sanders. Then again, I should tell you, there have only been two polls of the Democratic race in the past 5 months in Arizona. The number crunchers over at 538.com say they won't even forecast what's going to happen in the Arizona primary because there's just not enough data to base any forecast on. So it should also be noted that Bernie Sanders is making a very serious play for the state of Arizona. He's held a whole bunch of events across the state in the last week. And I mean, look at the time right now. Look how late it is right now as I speak to you. Bernie Sanders still has yet another rally planned for later tonight in Flagstaff, Arizona, with Hillary Clinton spots featuring beloved former Arizona Congresswoman Gabby Giffords. So Arizona is the big contest tomorrow. On the Democratic side, both candidates are fighting really, really, really hard for Arizona. And yes, I know what the polls say, but two polls in 5 months, I don't really think anybody knows what's going to happen in Arizona on the Democratic side tomorrow for sure. We won't know until we see it. On the Republican side, winning Arizona is a huge deal. Rebecca Sanders, congressional reporter for the Arizona Republic. Ms. Sanders, thanks very much for being here. I really appreciate your time.
Thanks for having me.
There has been very little polling in the state. There's been some here and there, but it feels like it's not really enough to extrapolate from. You've seen some of these candidates' ground games. You've seen their events close up. What's your sense of who's running the best campaign and who has the best shot on in each party?
I'd agree with your assessment. I don't think that an upset is possible here. Just from watching the ground games here and also talking to voters and just knowing the kind of temperament of voters here, I would say that Clinton and Trump have the best chance here. But as you said, the polling has been very sparse. In terms of events, Cruz did come through with a rally on Friday and a surprise visit to a church on Sunday morning. But I hear that even the campaign of supporters who are trying to get an upset for him just haven't been given the resources from the national campaign that they need. I think that's exactly it. The rallies here, the barnstorming that he's done across the state from north to south across this week, they have been huge crowds, extremely passionate. But, you know, one of the problems is that a lot of his supporters are young and independent, and this is a closed presidential primary in Arizona. And I've spoken with young voters who didn't even know that they needed to re-register with the Democratic Party to participate. And then also, right, Clinton's campaign has been very well mobilized for weeks now. They've just been much more disciplined, bigger staff, and while, you know, it does look like the grassroots support for Sanders, with this being a state with a long history of relationships with the Clintons, I just don't see him overcoming her.